again. Welcome back. Are you ready for the finale? Overdue pits Pico against Mr. L, a terrifying elongated version of Luigi. This track is based on TooLate.exe, a Mario fan game by Mr. Pixel Productions. The game itself takes place in Mario 3, though with a number of stark differences right away. Mario crying mournfully in the opening title, the lack of two-player mode, and there being no enemies in the first level. Before being able to complete this level, Mario breaks down again, but is perked up by the sound of his brother Luigi's voice. Running into the endless abyss beyond the first level, Mario does find his brother, albeit radically changed. As the story goes, Mario accidentally killed his brother by having him fall into lava. Whether this death was caused directly or indirectly by Mario remains vague throughout the story by design, but it still remains that Luigi's vengeful soul has returned. Mr. L pays back his brother with a unique type of torture, designing scary body horror-themed levels to chase his brother through. A few mechanics include having to frequently turn around to dispel Mr. L from grabbing the player, and hiding behind walls to avoid his gaze. Regardless of the player's actions throughout TooLate, Luigi eventually kills his brother the same way Mario did him. In Mario's Madness, we're given another cutscene pertaining to the main story of the mod. Pico visits boyfriend and girlfriend, likely due to not hearing from them in a while, and notices a giant red staticky television. He too is pulled into the bloody cartridge, but skips right past Horror Mario and straight to Mr. L. Just like in TooLate, Mr. L has his back turned, appearing like a usual docile Luigi until revealing himself to Pico. True to Pico's character, partway through the song we're introduced to the gun mechanic. Having bullets appear on the strum line, the player can press to fire a shot at Mr. L, damaging him enough to counteract his health drain. This mechanic also doubles as an alternate health, as missing more than three bullet notes empties Pico's magazine. The game over screen is a reference to the way Luigi eats Mario in TooLate. Mr. L phasing in and out while being shot at, and the screen fading is a reference to the apparition and darkness mechanics in TooLate. Eventually, while in the body horror stage of the song, Pico is joined by the burned ghost of Mario, confirming this song takes place after TooLate. The many Mr. L's during the final rush of the song is a reference to the end hallway of the game, where dozens upon dozens of Mr. L watch Mario run to his doom. Pico, however, makes it out of this scenario undipped in lava. Pico also briefly sings the motif of his first song, Pico, from the base game while making his escape. Yo soy Luigi. Now finally, to finish off, Hellish Heights are the songs Power Down and Demise, both songs telling two parts of one story, Mario 85. To summarize, Mario 85, or Mario PC port, is the story of a boy named Lucas who's playing the original Mario, but things aren't what they seem. While playing 1-1, he's interrupted by a large proportioned Mario saying his name, and is eventually chased by them. This creature is MX, a demonic spirit haunting the cartridge the player is using. The game over screen features Lucas's character decapitated on a spike before the whole scenario starts over again. Just like Mr. L, our opponent in Power Down disguises themselves as the original Mario 1 Mario, but quickly takes on their usual gigantic form. At this point, a POW block mechanic is introduced, having the player quickly jump to avoid ground-based damage, as failing to do so will have MX use his immense strength to turn boyfriend into goo. Though the POW block is used to visually represent the mechanic, the damage is actually coming from MX slamming into the ground. Looking in the background, we see both a decapitated Lucas and dead Toad, as well as a single-eyed Hill and Laughing Sun, as seen and described in Mario 85. After surviving Power Down, we move on to Demise, a song depicting the chase sequence segment of 85. No mechanics during the song, only non-stop rapid singing reflecting the intensity of the chase and the sadness of girlfriend getting squished. As it turns out, she is not so squished as thought, as she assists boyfriend over a massive gap. But as seen in 85, a gap ain't a thing to MX. After another gauntlet of a track, MX plays Unfair by sticking the song timer at 3 seconds remaining for a rapid-paced finale, but eventually, boyfriend makes it to the warp pipe. The fifth and final warp star brings us to Classified Castle, an entire world based on Mario 64 Classified, an analog horror series by Annie Log about the every copy of Mario 64's personalized rumors. The series features gameplay clips and commercials from the 90s surrounding the production of Mario 64, all of which were never intended to be released publicly. Though the entries are uploaded out of order, the series is best enjoyed being watched in that order, as the series actually has a tangible plot in which certain reveals are better saved for later episodes. Regardless, Mario 64 Classified covers a number of subjects we've already discussed in previous songs of Mario's Madness. Since the entire world is based on one series, every game over in Classified Castle is a slowly approaching faceless Mario known as Stanley. The eerie music in the background is sampled from the Beatles song Revolution 9, adding to the creepy effect of this game over. Stanley is the personification of Mario 64's personalization AI, and appears frequently throughout Classified as the series' main focus. Stanley originally went by Auto_Enhancer by the devs in Classified, but would eventually name themselves Stanley by inputting the name in Bacon's cipher code at the end of the episode Aftermath. Promotion is the first song in Classified Castle and is based on the promo show episode of Classified, which features an unused pilot for the show Nintendo Mania, hosted by Mario. Promotion Mario's Way of Speaking is based on the Super Mario Super Show version of Mario, who has a deeper voice and Brooklyn accent, the standard for Mario's voice before Charles Martinet. The reason the cutscene and song have two different art styles is because the cutscene was made long after wrapping production of the song. Promo Show is a showcase of an early build of Mario 64, as Luigi is a playable character in early versions of the game. When an underwater Luigi appears on Promotion Mario's TV screen, his attitude changes as he realizes his brother's fate. The second half of Promotion with a frontward-facing Mario, Luigi, and Peach is based on the ending of 09-14-96. Also, the opponent is no longer Promotion Mario and is now Stanley, having taken over control of the song. The next song, Abandoned, focuses on El Israel Luigi, similar to another track from earlier in the mod. Abandoned and Thalassophobia share a ton of themes between them, as well as similar mechanics. Pressing special notes decreases the water level and prevents the player and Luigi from drowning. Luigi's starting and 3D appearance is based on his classified counterpart as seen in 09-02-97, though very briefly. Though El Israel Luigi is Promotion Mario's brother, since Stanley is the personification of Mario 64's code, he feels just as mournful of Luigi's death as if he were his brother, since it was a part of himself that died when Luigi was removed from 64 due to drowning. Just like Abandoned Luigi, the end is based on another character only briefly seen in Classified, Costume. Costume is also from 09-02-97 like Luigi, as seen in the distorted end screen. Costume is supposed to be a character central to the story of Classified, but the focus shifted towards Stanley as the series progressed, so they're instead just an eerie visual. And with that, we see off Classified Castle and head for the finale, but we'll always remember, Nintendo's fun is eternal. With the 5 warp stars completed, the player is left with the stark realization. They need to go back the way they came. The actual final level is through a new glitchy warp pipe and down a long walk, all the while Horror Mario reminds us that it's time to finish the 3-song deal. The finale of the main story of Mario's Madness culminates in All Stars, an 8.5-minute song that pits Boyfriend against not only Horror Mario, but numerous other opponents we've seen throughout the mod under his control. The name All Stars comes from the compilation game Super Mario All Stars, and is fitting considering how many opponents are in this track. The song is divided into 4 acts, each act containing a different combination of artists and musicians. Act 1 begins with Horror Mario flipping through various forms before settling on his new appearance, Ultra M. Ultra M is much taller than his previous form, with 4 arms, several black tendrils sprouting from his back, and a giant pair of eyes sprouting from his hat, like Mario Odyssey's Cappy. All Stars was originally going to be for GB's 3rd song in his week before being reduced to just 1 song in Hellish Heights. Act 2 of All Stars features an entirely new character, Omega. He's most recognized by the iconic Omega symbol on his hat and his Tanuki suit. He was created by Ultra M to distract Boyfriend during this part of the song, even giving this new character underlings to help. They're named LG, War, and Yosh, respectively. Though the character and stage is based on Super Mario 3, the only of Omega's underlings that actually appeared in the game is Luigi. Since Super Mario 3 takes place on a stage, Omega has a showmanship to him, as seen by him bowing out when his underlings arrive. The final 2 acts bring back Ultra M, and this time he's got something new to show us. While Boyfriend was distracted by Omega, Girlfriend was killed and turned into a puppet by Ultra M, much to the dismay of Boyfriend. This puppet is controlled by Ultra M, singing and moving with Girlfriend's voice while also singing himself during Act 3, meaning Girlfriend has been assimilated into Ultra with the rest of the mod's cast. Ultra reminds Boyfriend he is now alone, before entering the 4th and final act of All Stars. Act 4 takes place in a vacuous void, with many broken and distorted props orbiting around the 2 central characters. Ultra M is now massive, especially compared to Boyfriend, and now flexes his power as ruler of this domain. Ultra will sing the motif of various songs throughout Mario's Madness, and when doing so, his health icon is joined by the character whose song he's singing. After a lamenting solo, Boyfriend releases his anger in the finale of All Stars, but unfortunately, it still isn't enough. At the end of All Stars, Boyfriend is killed, making Mario Madness one of the few mods to kill Funkin's protagonist. As the credits roll, a haunting song called It's a Mad, Mad World plays, bookending the main story of the mod. The final slide is a very much still-alive Pico discovering the puppet-fied bodies of Boyfriend and Girlfriend. In an interview with Meditera, Mario Madness director Marco Antonio revealed that they decided to kill the couple in this mod because they wanted the ending to be memorable, but also because the team wasn't interested in making a version 3. In the same interview, he revealed that Pico is the sole survivor and wanders Horror Mario's world unable to find an exit. Perhaps in a future hotfix update, we can get that little guy out of there. Legacy versions of Mario Madness songs can be played from the free play menu, allowing access to the original 8 tracks. One of these tracks is Forbidden Star, the second now removed Apparition Wario track. Remember the last Mario Madness video when I said I had to call Luigi to get help with No Party? Well, this mechanic is a reference to Mario Maker 2's story mode. If a player is having difficulty beating a certain level, they can call Luigi to beat it for them. Which is why in Mario's Madness, calling Luigi is offered after dying a certain amount of times in a song. That's not the only Mario Maker reference, as Undo Dog and Core Spot can be seen on the main menu. Speaking of the main menu, the song that plays in the main menu is the Mario rap from the Mario movie. After completing every song in the mod so far, the player is informed that there's something new in Hellish Heights they should look at. This is the official final song of the mod, Unbeatable. Unbeatable is against Mr. Sis, which isn't short for system like initially thought, but is an acronym for Steal Your Soul. The character originates from an Australian commercial for the NES, in which Mr. Sis informs the player they cannot beat the villains of Mario and Duck Hunt. Despite appearing after the player beats the main story as a bonus song, Mr. Sis still appears in Act 4 of All-Stars, simply due to the two songs being wrapped up at the same time. Since Mr. Sis is the only character in Unbeatable not to be from a video game, it can be assumed based on his color scheme that he is the embodiment of the NES. Funnily enough, I actually can't beat this, and it's way funnier if I never do. The song is literally unbeatable. And that's 10 things about Mario's Madness, more like 30 things at this point, but you know what's up. It was quite the undertaking, but I had a lot of fun making this, and I hope you enjoyed. Until next time.